A group of nine Forum for Democratic Change Katunga faction members were arrested by police as they attempted to march to Kenya High Commission to deliver a protest note today. Were arraigned before the court presided over by Justice Ronald Kaizi to tender in their bail application. Represented by Edias Lukwago as defense lawyer, the suspects urged the court to grant them bail unconditionally due to what they called a low gravity of the case they are charged with.
But for the sureties, they are here, you watch for all their documentation. They are here.
All the applicants have not complied the mandatory provision.
Their plea was, however, contested by the prosecution lawyer Ivan Chaze, saying that the defendants had failed to meet the conditions for bail. The defense lawyer Lukwago persuaded the court to accept national IDs and LC letters as documents to grant bail to the accused, a matter that court agreed to.
We can run around once you have granted them on that condition that whoever brings the letter or the ID, here it is. That would be fair, your worship.
The court then granted each of the accused a non-cash bail of 1 million shillings and 5 million shillings for each surety. The case was adjourned to 4th September this year.
And is the accused persons on a court bond of 1 million not cash. Each of the accused has executed a bond of 5 million not cash. Each accused person has to comply with paragraph 12 of the bail guidelines.
Defense lawyer Edias Lukwago said it is going to challenge the condition of bail application in the Constitutional Court. The 36th Forum for Democratic Change Katunga faction members were arrested in Kisumu County near the Ugandan border while attending a leadership training. Police, however, stated that they were in Kenya to receive terrorism training, in a move that has been widely condemned by human rights activists. First Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of East African Community Affairs, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, has expressed concern over the locals who have engaged in rampant land sale, resulting in high poverty levels in Busoga sub-region. Kadaga cautioned residents against selling their land and also stop land fragmentation, but focus on growing food crops at a large scale so that they could increase income in their households. Kadaga expressed condemnation of this practice as she flagged off the Busoga Consortium for Development's Village Agriculture Model Initiative, aimed at improving agriculture production and transforming the lives of people in Busoga sub-region and Uganda at large.
I want to thank you for the commitment, thank you for the sacrifice, thank you for coming to stay in our country. How long are you going to be here for this route?
Busoga Consortium for Development organized a trail to commission village agriculture model selected villages in the Busoga sub-region, where Kadaga, the patron of BCD, was the chief guest. Kamala Harris made her debut Tuesday with a new White House running mate Tim Walz, who unleashed a stinging rebuke of their Republican rival Donald Trump, questioning his commitment to the country and skewering his record in office. Hours after being announced on the Democratic ticket, the Minnesota governor took to the stage with Vice President Harris in the crucial swing state of Pennsylvania and signaled his intent to press the case aggressively against Trump. He accused Trump of deliberately weakening the economy for his own ends, mocking law and order, and sowing chaos and division.
Again and again and again, Trump weakens our economy to strengthen his own hand.
With less than 3 months to go until Election Day, most Americans do not know who Walz is, and he gave voters a glimpse of his personal story, describing his military service, his experience as a public school teacher, and his record in politics. Harris, 59, described Walz as a leader who will help unite our nation and move us forward, a fighter for the middle class, and a patriot who believes, as I do, in the extraordinary promise of America. A former Attorney General of California, Harris has sought to draw a contrast between her past as a prosecutor and Trump's criminal record, which extends to 34 felonies, with over a dozen more charges pending.